If you were going to write code for instructions to serve a tennis ball using BASIC, the instruction would look something like this. You have a verb, serve, and then a noun, ball. VBA, which is an object-oriented language, doesn't work like this. In an object-oriented language, the objects, nouns, are most important. So, the instructions to serve a ball in tennis using VBA will be as follows. In VBA, ball is an object, and the serve is a method. The basic structure of VBA has this syntax. For almost any object in VBA, there is a collection of that object. You don't have only one ball. There are a soccer ball, basketball, volleyball, and tennis ball. When you refer to something that is a collection, you have to tell the programming language to which item you are referring. You can refer to an item by using a number. The only difference between an object and a collection is that you add an S to the name of the object. For example, if the tennis ball is the fourth ball, you could type. A better way is to use a name for the object in a collection instead of numbers. You could also add some parameters for the method. Some methods simply act on their own. To simulate pressing the F9 key, you use this code. It's also important that objects have properties. Just as adjectives describe a noun, properties describe an object. For example, an object is an active cell and has the following name code. If you want to change the height of the cell, you can type. This can be confusing because a property is similar to method, but don't worry if it all seems confusing right now. When you are writing VBA code from scratch, it's tough to know whether the process of changing a cell to red or changing the height requires a verb or an adjective. Is it a method or a property? This is where a macro recorder is especially helpful. When you don't know how to code something, you record a short little macro. Look at the recorded code and figure out what is going on. Also, Excel VBA help is extremely useful. You can highlight any word of any line of code, for example, active cell, and by pressing F1, you will see the help topic for the active cell object. Now it's time to record the macro and see whether it makes more sense now that you know about objects, properties, and methods. Return to Excel. From Developer tab, press the Record Macro button. Okay, first select a range of cells, for example from D10 to G20. Make them bold. Then color the background with yellow color. Change also the font color to red. And lastly, change the font size to 10. Stop recording. Press Alt F11 to return to VBA editor. Here is the code. The sub statement defines the name of the macro, which is macro 1. These line codes with green font color are comments. To let Excel VBA know what you want to insert, a comment, precede the text with an apostrophe. These lines select the range from D10 to G20. Do you remember the object.methodBasic VBA syntax? Well, range is the object and select is the method. The next line makes the font bold. Font.bold is a property. The following lines of code change the background of the cell to yellow. We will learn the with and with statements in the next lesson. These Excel Solid or Excel Automatic are constants that are predefined in Excel VBA. We will talk about constants in following lessons. These lines change the font color to red, and these change the font size to 10. Generally, a macro runs quickly. You start it, and less than a second later, it's done. If something goes wrong, you do not have an opportunity to figure out what the macro is doing. However, using Excel's Step Into feature makes it possible to run one line of code at a time. To use this feature, make sure your cursor is in the procedure you want to run, and then from the menu, select Debug, Step Into. Alternatively, you can press F8. The VBA editor is now in break mode. The line about to be executed is highlighted in yellow, with a yellow arrow in the margin before the code. In this case, the next line to be executed is the sub-macro 1 line. This basically says you are about to start running this procedure. Press the F8 key to execute the line in yellow and move to the next line of code. Press F8 again to run the next line. If you switch to Excel, you will see the execution of the macro. In a later lesson, we will see more debugging options. That's it for today. I hope you understood the basic structure of VBA language. I want to thank you for watching this lesson, and I will see you in the next lecture. Bye! I hope you enjoyed the lesson. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so already, so that you can get updates when I put out new videos here. I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video tutorial.